Today's Your Daily Prayer Devotional is sponsored by the David Caleb Cook Foundation. If our podcast has been a blessing in your life, would you consider helping us get Bibles to children in Muslim countries? Go to davidcalebcook.org/dailyprayer to donate. Your gift will help send God's Word to children around the world.
Hey everyone, thanks for joining us for the Your Daily Prayer Podcast. We hope these few moments of prayer and reflection are encouraging to you as you go about your day. To get all of our episodes straight to your phone during the week, just subscribe to this podcast on iTunes or wherever you listen to your podcast. To find more prayers, devotional content, and blog posts, we would love for you to join us at ibelieve.com.
A Prayer to Kill the Sin of Gossip in Your Life by Michelle Lazarek, read by Leah Martin. Don't let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. Ephesians 4:29. Can you pray for Jan? I heard she's having some issues in her marriage. I think they're on the brink of divorce. In my 16 years of ministry, I've had many women come to me and start off a conversation just like this one. Yet a conversation like this is nothing more than gossip, thinly veiled as a prayer request used as a way to share information about another member of church. If I'm honest, it's easier speaking about someone else's life rather than my own. I even get a little joy out of hearing someone else's problems. For a moment, it seems like my life is better than someone else's. I can temporarily indulge in the spiritual high of knocking someone else off her pedestal in a pathetic attempt to keep me on my pedestal. Perhaps you, like me, have experienced the high of hearing about someone else's problems. Have you thrived even a little bit on the idea that someone who on the outside is thinner, prettier, or better than you is crumbling on the inside? God meant for words to have power. God used words when he spoke the world into being. Jesus used them to calm storms, heal the sick, and rebuke the Pharisees. In the same way, our words can have a positive or negative effect on people, depending on which we choose to use. Are you speaking words that heal or words that hurt? Let's pray together now for the power we need to kill the sin of gossip. Lord, thank you for your mercy and grace, even when we sin and gossip. Help me see this sin for what it is, hateful, hurtful, and ultimately, sin that separates me from you. Lord, give me a greater affection for you. Help me love you so much that it spills over into everyone I meet. Help me love you so much that the temptation to gossip melts away in the midst of my thankfulness and joy. Help me long to build others up, not tear them down. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Did you know that children between the ages of 4 and 14 are 4 times more likely to accept Christ than they will be as adults? And that need to share the gospel and the love of Jesus with precious children is even greater in the Muslim world, where many never hear about Christ's love for them. You can help lead children in Muslim countries to Jesus by sending them a Bible through the David Caleb Cook Foundation. Your gift will send a colorful, comic-style action Bible that connects with kids so they can know the hope of Jesus. So please, give your best gift today at davidcalebcook.org/dailyprayer and watch as God transforms these children to transform their world.